The Jewish holiday Pesach, or Passover, tells the story of how the Jewish people escaped slavery in Egypt. Its themes of fighting oppression and seeking liberation are an example of the ties between Jewish theology and social justice. It all started when a new pharaoh came to power in Egypt. He saw that the Jewish people were prosperous and growing, and he didn't like this threat to his power. The pharaoh decided to enslave the Jews, forcing them to build monuments in his image and ordering the drowning of all newborn Jewish males. Jocheved, a Jewish woman, gives birth to a son. Fearing for his life, she places him in a basket and sends him floating down the Nile River. He is discovered by the pharaoh's daughter, who takes him in and names him Moses. Moses grows up in the palace, but knows he is a Jew. As he gets older, he begins to notice the conditions of his people. One day, Moses sees an Egyptian beating a Jewish man. He is so enraged, he kills the Egyptian, forcing him to flee the palace. Moses goes into hiding as a shepherd, but the Jewish people's conditions worsen. One day, God speaks to Moses through a burning bush, telling him to go to Pharaoh and ask him to free the Jews. Moses goes to Pharaoh multiple times, but he continually refuses to free the Jewish slaves. God sends 10 plagues upon Egypt, from swarms of frogs, to pestilence that kills Egyptian livestock, to complete darkness cast over the land. When Pharaoh continues to refuse, God is forced to send the 10th plague, the death of all firstborn Egyptian sons. The Jewish people paint the blood of a lamb over their doors so that God will pass over them when descending on Egypt. Pharaoh finally breaks, telling the Jews to leave his land. However, as they are leaving, Pharaoh changes his mind again and pursues them with his army. Moses places his staff in the Red Sea, which splits and allows the Jews to pass through. It then crashes down, swallowing Pharaoh and his army. The Jews were finally free. You